Okay, we said we're going to start the dinim of Tishrei, Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Sukkot. There's a lot of dinim, and we don't have enough time to learn everything. Okay, so we learned already that you blow shofar for the whole month of Elul. Okay, why? Because Moshe Rabbeinu went up to the mountain the last 40 days. It's a time of rachamim. It's a time of shofar. It's a wake-up call. Says you talk a shofar ba'ir v'abla yecharadu. If you blow shofar in the city, won't the people tremble? It's basically a wake-up call in the month of Elul to do tshuva. Now you don't blow shofar on erev Rosh Hashanah. Why don't you blow shofar on erev Rosh Hashanah? So there's two reasons. One is to differentiate between the customary blowing of Elul, which is only minhag, versus the biblical obligation of Rosh Hashanah itself. So to separate between the custom and the mandatory, we don't blow erev Rosh Hashanah. Another answer given in Halacha is because we want to mix up the Satan. So simply the expression is, the Satan would think that Rosh Hashanah went by already. So you don't blow erev Rosh Hashanah, the Satan thinks, oh, it's probably Rosh Hashanah, I missed it, so goodbye, you know, try next year again. Which is a very difficult thing to understand. How stupid do you think the Satan is? Let him look in a calendar and he'll see right away where Rosh Hashanah is. You think you're going to fool him? He can find out exactly when the real Rosh Hashanah is. So the real explanation of what it means that you want to mix up the Satan doesn't mean, God forbid, that the Satan shouldn't know when Rosh Hashanah does. But the expression is that he thinks Rosh Hashanah passed. It means as follows. Elul is a month of tshuva. Shofar wakes the Jews up to do tshuva. When it comes erev Rosh Hashanah, the Jews finish the whole month of Elul in doing tshuva, preparing for the new year. The Satan sees that he has nothing to come complain about because the Jews finished tshuva already. What it means, la'ariv is a Satan means, when the Satan sees Jews are not blowing shofar and erev Rosh Hashanah because the Jews finished doing tshuva already, so as far as the Satan is concerned, the Rosh Hashanah means they were forgiven already. So what am I going to come for? But not that the Satan is a foolish thing. Satan's a malach. I mean, the Satan is brilliant. He knows when Rosh Hashanah is. But by the Jews blowing shofar and doing tshuva, as far as he's concerned, the Rosh Hashanah passed, meaning the Jews did tshuva already. But out of Rosh Hashanah, it says you're not allowed to blow shofar. But what happens if somebody wants to practice because they have to blow on Rosh Hashanah? They need to practice or whatever. So it says in a closed room, you're allowed to practice shofar even on erev Rosh Hashanah. Now, as far as sliches goes, you know, the Sfardim have the whole month of Elul, they do sliches.
You don't blow shofar every day.
Huh?
You don't blow shofar.
I thought they blow after sliches, no?
You don't blow.
Some do, some don't.
We blow it only. After,
do you know that the story is told, there was a new rabbi and came to town, and people in that town were always fighting about what the custom is. So now that the new rabbi comes to town, so one guy comes into the rabbi and he says, isn't the custom in this city to do ABC? The rabbi says, you're right. The other guy with the different custom comes and says, isn't the custom in this city ABC? He says, you're right. So the rabbi's wife says to him, how can they both be right? He says, you're also right. That's the way Jews are. You know, that's the beauty of Judaism, that there's so many different customs, especially when they fight over them. Anyway, but in the Sephardic community, they say Slichas a whole Elul plus the 10 days of repentance. In the Ashkenazi communities, we say Slichas either the Shabbos before Rosh Hashanah or a week and a half before Rosh Hashanah. Now, what is the dependent on? You need to have a minimum of 4 days of Slichas. You're supposed to have a minimum, corresponding with the 4 days between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, you're not allowed to fast. Anyway, the bottom line is, so we have a minimum of 4 days of Slichas. Now, if Rosh Hashanah is Thursday and Friday, so then you have Saturday night, which is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Okay, then you have it. Rosh Hashanah is Monday, or this year Tuesday, or if it's if Rosh Hashanah is Shabbos and Sunday, then again you begin the Saturday night before, and then you have a whole week. But because Rosh Hashanah this year is Tuesday and Wednesday, or if Rosh Hashanah would be Monday and Tuesday, so then you don't have 4 days of Slichas, because we always want to begin Slichas Saturday night. Why? Because the main Slich of Saturday Menucha, and therefore the custom is you really properly are not supposed to do Slichas until Chatzeis Laila, until midnight, because on Shabbos, Saturday night, still a continuation of Shabbos, even though most shuls do it today, but whatever. So therefore, we begin always Saturday night. So this year is the longest possible Slichas, the days of Slichas in Ashkenazi community. We have from Sunday, Monday, Saturday night, through the whole week, and then again Sunday, Monday. So it's the longest possible Slichas we ever say, every one of the Slichas this year. Now, what else I want to say about, most people, by the way, say Aseres Yimei Tshuva. Chabad doesn't, just in same Gedalia, because it's a fast day. We say Slichas like we would on any fast day. Now, the Chazan wears a talus for Slichas. He doesn't make a bracha on it unless it's going to be his talus that he's davening with, and it's after the time you're allowed to say a bracha. Anyway, okay. That's that. And, it's very important. If you're having a minyan for Slichas, you don't say Asherei until there's 10 people in the room. Even by way of mincha, let's say you're davening mincha and you have 9 people in the room, so you say, okay, the 10th guy's coming in a minute, we'll say Asherei, and as soon as he walks in, we'll say Kaddish. It says in Halacha, you're not allowed to start Asherei until there's a minyan in the room. No, mincha, slichus also. We start slichus always with Asherei. Okay, so you can't say, unless, if you're waiting for a minyan, if you're doing it by yourself, obviously you do it. But if you're expecting a minyan any minute, okay, so then I'm saying, then you would say, you don't say Asherei until there's a minyan, because the Kaddish after Asherei is going on the Asherei, which should be said with a minyan. So if there's no minyan, you wait until actually...
Catch up later,
whatever, I don't know, it's a million things. But
I heard that the one who does blow the shofar has to have certain qualification. I don't remember which one was it. Was it Kippur or Rosh Hashanah that it's not as important?
No, there's just two aspects in all of this. There's the Chazan, and then there's the one that blows shofar. The Chazan has to be somebody who's God-fearing, has a family, because then when he davens, he has he's more sincere in his davening. A person that has good midas, good character in Yiras Shamayim. Baal Tekeah, it says, should be a chacham, who knows the halachas, and an extremely God-fearing, more than a chazan. In other words, you're more meticulous about a person blowing shofar. First of all, he has to be expert in halachas, because when he's blowing, he has to know if you made a mistake, where you go back, where you don't go back, what you do. I mean, those are complicated halachas in the blowing of the shofar. Nevertheless, it says also that the proper, it says in Shulchan Aruch, that the Baal Tekeah should be a tzaddik, hogun, you know, a very holy person. Yeah.
For both Yom
Kippur? No, Yom Kippur at the end is just the custom to blow the shofar. No. I know everybody comes back. It's very interesting. In the world, everybody comes back for the shofar blowing at the end of Yom Kippur. Okay, it's really, in halacha, it's just to show that the Shechina left. I mean, it's basically not a very important aspect of but by people, it's the same thing if you think about it. In many, many shuls, especially the not-so-religious shul, Kol Nidrei is mobbed. More than Yom Kippur Day. What's the tefillah of Kol Nidrei? The prayer of Kol Nidrei is really nothing special. It's basically you're saying, with the three people around the chazan, as a bezin, you're saying, any vow that we made, will be null and void. I mean, it's not... Why do people? It's the opening of Yom Kippur, so mentally it's a very But you know, Ne'ilah actually is the holiest part of Yom Kippur, not the shofar at the end of Ne'ilah. Ne'ilah is the holiest part of Yom Kippur. If a person could only come to shul, like, for one thing, that whatever, they should come for Ne'ilah. Ne'ilah is the holiest time of Yom Kippur.
Well, we're going back to the someone being chacham in addition to
yeah. What's the yardstick? For some people, you need a millimeter ruler that has 1 millimeter and it'll be enough. Well, how do you estimate? There is a din in Shulchan Aruch. What happens if there's two places to go to? One has shofar blowing, but no davening, and one has davening, but not shofar blowing. Notice in the time of the Gemara is very common. They had, you know, the shtetlach, the small. So then the halacha is you go to a place of shofar because shofar is biblical.
The
shofar is a biblical mitzvah. He has to be a great person to blow shofar. Yeah. Okay, very quickly. Erev Rosh Hashanah, we do a Hataras Nudarim, nullification of vows. Mitzvah Shem, tomorrow night we'll talk more about it. This year is something special at Hataras Nudarim. This coming year, 5782, Tavshin Pei Beis, is a Shemitah year, a sabbatical year. And therefore, rabbinically, in the biblical times, if a person had a debt, Shemitah takes away the debt, and you're not allowed to collect the debt, and so on. Nowadays, we don't have biblical Shemitah because we don't have a base of Mikdash, and not all the Jews are in it, so whatever. But nevertheless, it says that Alter Rebbe brings down, you should do what's called a prusbul. And tomorrow night, Mr. Shem will talk about prusbul.